Tervetuloa taas Kuningaskunnan tuuliohjelmasarjan pariin. Tässä jaksossa katsomme, kuinka Jumalan henki yhdistää kansakuntia Israeliin. Edellisessä jaksossa näimme, miten Haifassa järjestetyssä Elav-konferenssissa Pyhä Henki yhdisti arabit ja juutalaiset ja kuinka he juhlivat yhteyttä. Tässä elokuussa 2013 pidetyssä konferenssissa oli mukana myös suuri ryhmä nuoria Indonesiasta. Indonesia on maa, jossa on maailman suurin muslimiväestö. Jumalan tuuli kuitenkin puhaltaa tällä hetkellä Indonesiassa voimalla, ja sen seurauksena indonesialaisia on alkanut kasvavassa määrin vierailla Israelissa. Andy Jokro on yksi Indonesian muutoksen johtajista. Miksi indonesialaiset ovat alkaneet käydä Israelissa?
Many Indonesian, many Christian, they came to Israel and they not just come as a tourist, but they came to bless Israel.
Indonesian saarivaltiossa asuu maailman eniten muslimeja. Islamilaista lakia siellä ei kuitenkaan ole. 10 vuotta sitten maassa alkoi suuri mullistus. Mitä Indonesiassa oikein on tapahtunut?
In 2003, churches start talking about, you know, impacting the nations, not just a minority, not just like a church organization, but we have to stand as an nation to change our country.
Kun kirkkojen johtajat sitten kokoontuivat yhteen, Jumalan henki tuli.
The anointing of unity just fell down to that room. I was there and I saw, you know, leaders. They are big leaders, like they have 200,000 congregation, 500,000. Then they start to embrace each other. They never talked to each other before, but suddenly we feel the spirit of unity just come, and they start washing feet each other. They start, you know, crying. And since that meeting, they said we have to do something. So the first they do is do the gathering in stadium in 2003 and declare transformation of Indonesia.
Heti tämän jälkeen Jumala alkoi ravisuttaa Indonesiaa.
You know, in 2004, 24 December, something happened. Probably the world knows about tsunami in Indonesia, right? In one night in Aceh, 200,000 people die. Shaking comes to Indonesia. So everybody is so scared. Earthquake like happened every day.
Tämä sai Indonesian uskovat tulemaan yhä tiiviimmin yhteen.
The churches decided to gather once again on the May 5th, 2005, 555. Now there are all churches to come together at every stadium in the nation to fasting and praying. We decided to really pray for the government. A lot of Christian in the government comes, a lot of businessmen, the seven mountains, the seven spears, they have come together and declare that Indonesia will have the transformation. So after the shaking, it's like we are ready for the revival.
Mitä sitten alkoi tapahtua?
It's something, I call it supernatural, but it's really God. A lot of, you know, non-believers, people is not Christian. They have, Jesus reveals himself to them through the dreams, through, you know, when they pray in their religion. A lot of testimony, unbelievers just call to the churches, who is this guy? I have a dream. A guy come with the nail pierce, you know, in his hand, and I saw these people with so bright and call his name is Jesus or Isa. Isa is one of the name of Jesus.
Elokuussa 2008 Indonesiassa järjestettiin The Call Indonesia -päivä.
1 million youth fasting and praying and declare the day of repentance of Indonesia. The theme is, can a nation be changed in one day? And start from there. It's kind of like the transformation is not just, you know, about fathers, leaders of churches, but God opens a new door, like two generations come together, like, you know, Moses and Joshua comes together. The next generation just fill it, all the tower of prayer filled with the young people. Many churches filled with the young leaders, young people. Many malls now in Indonesia opening the door for churches who young people come to the mall not just for shopping, but to worship the Lord.
Indonesiassa oli tuohon aikaan noin 160 miljoonaa muslimia. Osa heistä raivostui alkaneesta herätyksestä ja seurakunta on kohdannut julmaa vainoa. Viimeisen 10 vuoden aikana yli 2000 kirkkoa on poltettu, monia on pommitettu ja Jumalan palvelijoita on tapettu. Elisa Poluakan on nähnyt tätä vainoa läheltä. Elav-konferenssissa hän kertoi kokemuksistaan juutalais- ja arabinuorille.
Seorang hamba Tuhan sementara dia khotbah.
There was a lady pastor, she was speaking on the time Sunday service.
הייתה לנו מנהיגה אחת שלימדה באחד הערבים.
Saat itu ditembak tepat di atas di depan mimbar.
Somebody just came to her and shot her right on the head.
מישהו פשוט ניגש אליה וירה לה בראש.
דמיקן די דאר ג'ווה טימור.
This happened also on the eastern part of Java.
זה גם קרה בחלק המזרחי של ג'אווה.
זאורנג המבה תוהן יאנג סמנטרה לגי ברדואה.
This a pastor while he was praying.
רואה קהילה בזמן שהוא התפלל.
דיפוקול כפלניה.
Somebody hit him in the back of his head.
מישהו נתן לו מכה בחלק האחורי של הראש.
Lantas dibakar.
And they burned him alive.
Melabun seurakunta joutui pakenemaan tappajia vuorille.
But some of them get caught.
Aval hem tafsu khalak ma maaminim.
Bahkan ada seorang pastor yang disalib lantas dibakar.
There was a pastor who has been crucified and then been burned.
Kristityt olivat vihaisia ja katkeria ja rukoilivat Jumalan kostoa vainoajilleen. Kun he itkivät Jumalan edessä, Jumala alkoi puhua jotakin odottamatonta.
Setiap hari kami berdoa dengan sebuah harapan bahwa Tuhan pasti membunuh mereka.
Every day we pray as we hope, God, you will punish them, you will kill them.
והיינו מתפללים כמו שאנחנו רצינו שהוא יעניש אותם.
Semakin kami hancur hati,
but the more we have a broken heart,
אבל ככל שהלב שלנו נשבר יותר,
kami mulai tersungkur di hadirat Tuhan.
We start lying down, falling down, weeping in front of the presence of the Lord.
התחלנו פשוט לשכב, ליפול על הרצפה ולבכות בנוכחות של האדון.
תפי ג'וואבן דואן סנגת ברבדה.
But the answer of the Lord is so what we don't expect.
Jumala halusi antaa sydämensä heille, mutta sen vastaanottaminen ei ollut helppoa.
Kami berdoa bukan ini jawabannya Tuhan.
And we say, Lord, no, this is not the answer, Lord.
Kami ingin Tuhan membunuh mereka.
We want you to kill them, Lord.
Anakku rutin syata tarog otam.
Karena terlalu menyakitkan.
It's just too painful, Lord.
Zeo termidai keev.
Semakin kami menangis.
The more we cry,
וככל יותר שבכינו,
semakin kuat kasih Tuhan diberikan kepada kami.
Stronger and stronger love of God fall upon us.
אהבה של אלוהים נפלה עלינו חזק יותר ויותר.
Sampai satu titik kami harus menyerah.
In one point we just surrender.
ובאיזשהו שלב פשוט נכנענו.
Dan kami mulai berdoa.
We start praying.
התחלנו להתפלל.
Taruh hatimu terus Tuhan.
Lord, keep put your heart in our heart.
Elohim, itpalalnu Elohim, tasim et halev shelcha belibenu.
Berikan kasihmu untuk kami.
Give your love for us.
Jumalan rakkaus muuttui tuleksi heidän sydämissään ja muutti kaiken.
Makin kuat kasih itu melahir di dalam hidup kami.
when the love of God does get stronger being birthed in our life.
כשהאהבה של אלוהים מתחזקת יותר בחיים שלנו.
Dan kami bisa mengasihi orang-orang yang menyakiti kami.
You know what? We can start loving the one who persecute us.
אנחנו בעצם יכולים לאהוב את אלה שרודפים אותנו.
Dan kami sadar.
And we just realize.
ואנחנו הבנו.
Untuk melihat dan mengalami revival.
To see and to experience a revival.
כדי שאנחנו נוכל לראות ולחוות התעוררות.
דיבותוקן כסי תוהן.
You need the love of God.
צריך את אהבת אלוהים.
דיבותוקן הדי תוהן.
You need the heart of God.
צריך את הלב של אלוהים.
Karena di dalam kasih ada kuasa pengampunan.
Because in love there is a power of forgiveness.
כי באהבה יש את הכוח של הסליחה.
Seperti Bapa mengampuni dosa-dosa kita.
As Father forgive our sin.
כמו שהאב סולח את חטאינו.
Dan kami juga ingin mengampuni mereka yang menyakiti kami.
And we just want to forgive those who hurt us.
Tämän Pyhän Hengen antaman rakkauden kanssa he alkoivat mennä radikaalien muslimien luo ja osoittaa heille rakkautta.
Mereka mulai membuka diri.
They just opened themselves.
Empathuita lev shelem.
Dan tidak sedikit akhirnya mereka terima Tuhan Yesus.
And many of them received Jesus as a savior.
והרבה מהם קיבלו את האדון ישוע בתור המשיח שלהם.
Herätyksen alkaessa Indonesiassa kristittyjä oli viidennes kansasta. Nyt jo kolmasosa kansasta on kristittyjä ja 10 viime vuoden aikana uskoon on tullut yli 20 miljoonaa ihmistä. Heistä suurin osa on taustaltaan muslimeja. Yksi muslimitaustasta uskoon tullut on Joel Harahap.
When I was 24 years old, I just graduated from university and I work to one company in Jakarta. And those company, they always having what we call as prayer meeting every Saturday, sometime 1 week or sometime 1 month. It's only for the Christian employee. Then when they are having lunch or they're having this prayer meeting in the company between the break time, so they asked me to join. So I said to them, no, I can't join because I'm a Muslim. That time, then, but all these nice friends, everything they are sharing about the Christianity, they are sharing about who is Jesus. But that time, I'm not really bothered about that. And one of my close friends also introduced me about Christianity, introduced me about Christian, what is the Christian. And suddenly, one day, I didn't know what is going on with myself. I believe now, and after I understand who is Father, who is Jesus, and who is Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit has touched me, and also God asked me to go to the church. And that time, this is 26 years ago, I only know is one church. Then I come to those church in the early morning, 6 a.m. in the morning. Then they start the worship. I don't know what is going on.
Joel istui kirkon nurkassa kokouksen loppuun ja mietti, onko Jeesus todella täällä.
Is really Jesus in here? Is I ask myself, I question myself. Then because I got no idea and I don't know what is the pastor said about the Bible or the preaching. And suddenly he said after the meetings, after the sermon, he said there is an announcement for all the congregation who will be follow the baptism of water. Next week he mentioned about the name. Then I knew if want to follow Jesus, must be baptized. Then I asked myself, if really Jesus in here, I want him to talk to the pastor the baptism is not next week, but next week. Actually, I feel like talk to myself like bit the arrogant, like bit the the mocking or something like that to the pastor. And what is going after the benediction, after the blessings prayer, and the pastor is stand up, and he make a re-announcement because of some reason that the baptism should be conduct next week, but we change to next week. Then I'm in the corner, I really shocked, I surprised that God in here, Jesus in here. Then with no idea, no guidance and everything, I come again. I want to see what is going on in the baptism.
Hän meni myös itse sinä päivänä kastettavaksi ja kääntyi kristityksi. Joel Harahap, mikä oli suurin tämän kääntymyksen mukanaan tuoma muutos omassa elämässäsi?
First of all, I have Holy Spirit. When Jesus went to heaven, I have Holy Spirit. Regardless, whatever the circumstance facing us, it's always a hardship in our life. But with the Holy Spirit, we always have a peace in our heart.
Muslimikasvatuksen saaneen ja muslimikodissa kasvaneen Joelin mukaan Israelin Jumala ei ole sama kuin Allah.
For me, when I learn the Bible, is it not same God? Our God that we know in the name of Jesus, the God of Israel, the God that Israel worship, to Abba Father in heaven.
Miten Israelin Jumala sitten eroaa islamin Jumalasta?
The difference is, first is love. The second one is about character. Jesus show us who is our Father. Who is our Father in heaven? Who is, not only image of God in us, but is who is Father. And is reflected to Jesus' life when he has this great character among the Jewish people. Become savior for all of us, Gentile. This is because of he is showing the character of Father. This is really touched me, that from day to day, I want to be like him with his character, to showing our love to everybody, to our neighbors, even though to our enemy. This is Jesus. Jesus never taught us about to fight anyone who against us. But Jesus asks us to embrace everyone. This is the difference. This is what I know. It's not talking about like follower, like you conquer, you take over the city, you take over the nation. Jesus never teach us about that. Jesus teach us to become the salt, to become the light.
Tämän rakkauden vaikutuksesta tässä maailman suurimmassa muslimiväestöisessä maassa tapahtuu ihmeellisiä asioita.
If you come to Indonesia now, many open door crusades because Muslim open their city. A lot of cities never have the crusades before, but now they open it because they when the crusades happening in that city. Healing comes, the city becomes better, become more secure, become, no more corruption. So they're opening the door for crusades to come because they believe this kind of gathering impacting the nation, impacting the city.
Indonesian herätyksen takana on voimakas rukous. Ympäri maata on rukouspaikkoja, joita indonesialaiset kutsuvat rukoustorneiksi. Andy Chokro, mistä niissä on kysymys?
Prayer towers, what believe prayer towers is once about unity. We did it first in unity in 2003. Two is about corporate prayer. Praise and worship together as a body of Christ. Three is about high place. The place where you are really praying, speaking blessing for the nation.
Montako rukoustornia Indonesiassa on?
Honestly, I cannot answer that, but I believe it's more than 1,000, but I need to check again.
Rukoillaanko niissä lakkaamatta ympäri vuorokauden?
Yes, they are. It's not every prayer tower do it, but every, we call it city, at least they have one 24 hours. Covering all cities in Indonesia, covering all provinces in Indonesia.
Toukokuussa 2012 Indonesian pääkaupungissa Jakartassa järjestettiin kansainvälinen rukoustapahtuma World Prayer Assembly, jonne tuli noin 100,000 indonesialaisen rukoilijan tueksi liki 10,000 rukoilijaa yli 200 maasta. He rukoilivat yhdessä Jeesusta Indonesian pääksi. Andy Chokro, mikä on innostanut indonesialaiset rukoilemaan?
So people start excited to go to prayer tower because they see the result. I believe that this is it. The praying should be opening a miracle. Praying should be opening a new season for a nation. So when people start seeing that, you know, prayer tower really the key of harvest, the key of, you know, a soul harvest, they just love to pray. It's kind of like the new anointing of hunger and thirst to pray. We opening the stadium, we opening every place. You will see, you know, office tower, they have prayer tower over there. We see hotels, you know, where they open a door for a room just for a prayer tower. It's just like God give us favors. Businessmen, mall owners, hotel owners, they open it, the doors, because when people start praying in their business, blessing also comes for them. So it's like win-win solution.
Monet indonesialaiset ovat löytäneet myös toisen avaimen siihen, miten he valtiona ja kansakuntana voivat tulla siunatuksi.
We praying that someday, somehow, Indonesia will have a diplomatic relationship with Israel. But as right now, our country is really not supporting Israel. But we pray, because who bless Israel get blessed from the Lord. So we praying about it.
Israelin Jumala yhdisti myös entisen muslimin Israeliin.
Now I'm in the land of Israel. I couldn't imagine from Indonesia we can flew to Israel and in the promised land where Jesus teach about the Christian, when Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, all the prophets left in here, that now I'm in here because of Jesus, because of Holy Spirit, because of our Abba Father, the God of Israel. I know. I have a peace.
Nyt hän on käymässä Israelissa, mutta myös kotona Indonesiassa hän toimii Israelia tukevassa järjestössä.
And now I'm doing ministry, become the partner of Israel in our country.
Israel is very important for Indonesia. That's why we come to Israel very often. We come here almost every year and we pray for Indonesia and we take the fire from Israel go back to Indonesia. So we believe this it's going to be a significant in spiritual right now, even though we don't see it in the reality yet, connection, but I believe in spiritual we are building the bridge between Israel and Indonesia. We are supporting all the prayer towers here in Israel, almost every in a prayer movement in Israel. Messianic Jews have a very strong connection with the churches in Indonesia. Many church leaders, many we call the father of churches, come here and bless Israel. They are not just bless them to come here, but they bless them in material. They give their soul, their money to Israel. And I believe this is significant. And I can see many people who really bless Israel. They get blessing from the Lord. You know, churches become multiplied, business become multiplied. So I believe this is very significant that we have to build the relationship with Israel.
Ya Aba, ya Bapa, kami terus Tuhan mengangkat tangan kami, ya Bapa. Kami berkata Senajeb, kami berkata atas Barseba, kami berkata atas Bethlehem, kami berkata Yudea Samaria, kami berkata atas Galilee, kami berkata Saiva, kami berkata atas Israel, Shalom atas mereka semua Bapa. Aruha Babesham Adonai.
Tällaisten asioiden äärellä olimme tällä kertaa kuningaskunnan tuuliohjelmassa. Pyhä Henki kääntää tällä hetkellä kokonaisia kansoja Israelin Jumalan puoleen. Rukoillaan vielä yhdessä. Isä rakas, suo, että Suomi on niiden kansojen joukossa, jotka kansakuntana kääntyvät sinun puoleesi ja siunaavat sitä, mikä sinulle on rakasta.
Nämä kuningaskunnan tuuliohjelmat tuotetaan Israelissa katsojien lahjoittamilla varoilla. Jos sinä tahdot osallistua omalla panoksellasi näiden ohjelmien tekemiseen, soita ruudussa näkyvään numeroon 0600 100 77 tai anna lahjoituksesi pankkitilille.